My interest in occupational health really started with a personal tragedy, because when I was 12 years old, my dad was killed in a works accident. So many, many years later, when as a member of the UK cabinet, I was responsible for the health and safety executive and all the work that is undertaken under the commission, I realized that we needed to do something pretty drastic. And since then, there's been a lot of progress, but still not enough. And it's really about what's happening in the workplace. It's about whether managers, whether bosses really care, and whether workers take seriously what they have to do. So whether it's occupational lung disease or musculoskeleton disorders, or it's stress and mental health arising from what's happening at work, all of us have to take it seriously. It's a collaborative venture. It's mutually beneficial because it's a win-win. Individuals stay healthy. Employers don't lose time and productivity, and the nation don't lose the economic gains that comes from people staying at work, being healthy at work. So change for the better is fairly obvious. And I think what I just wanted to say to everyone is this is something to do with you. This is learning from what others are doing and then applying it. And really to ask a question, why wouldn't you? Why wouldn't you want to learn from what's working well, what actually has brought about improvements? Why would you want someone to be breathing in or experiencing, in terms of stress, something that you could alleviate? Why wouldn't you want to do it better? And it's a very simple question. Are you going to take responsibility as an individual worker, as a health and safety rep, as a manager, as a boss, to make your workplace healthier for you and for those you work with, and by doing so, create a healthier, a more effective and a more productive Britain?